Today we will discuss the second part, second lesson of your history book, 7th class history book, that is New Kings and Kingdoms. In my previous video, we have discussed about the division of history, or we can say about the classification of history and the rise of new kingdoms. But we have not discussed so many different clans which were emerged during medieval century. So today we will discuss about new kings and kingdoms which emerged during medieval century. Basically, in this video we will discuss about new kingdoms in India. And in new kingdoms in India, we will discuss about Gurjar Pratiharas. We will discuss about Rashtrakutas, Palas, Chahamans or Chohans, and at last we will discuss about Cholas. So at first we will discuss about Gurjar Pratiharas. Basically, this dynasty was established by King Harishchand, but the Pratiharas came into prominence in the middle of the 8th century AD when their king Nagbhat I defended western India from Arab invasions. Basically, Nagbhat I captured Kannauj, and Gurjar Pratihara dynasty was again established or revived by Raja Bhoj I in 836 AD. He took the title of Adivara as he was the devotee of Lord Vishnu. He was so brave that Chandelas, Kalchuris, Arab of Sindh acknowledged his supremacy. And an Arab traveler, Al-Masudi, came India at his time. So basically we can say this dynasty was established by Harishchand. Nagbhat I was the famous ruler. This was the area of Gurjar Pratiharas, and they were fighting for Kannauj. The dynasty was revived by Mihir Bhoj, who took the title of Adivara, and it was revived in 836 AD. Arab traveler Al-Masudi came at the time of Mihir Bhoj. Suleiman also visited his kingdom. And he used the term Al-Jurj. For Gurjar Pratiharas reign. Now we will see the second kingdom, that was Palas. This was the area of Pala dynasty, and their capital was Paharpur. Basically, Palas were ruling in Bengal and some parts of Bihar also. And this dynasty was founded by Gopala. So we can say Pala dynasty was founded by Gopala. Region which was being ruled by them, Bihar and Bengal. It is considered that Gopala displaced the later Guptas of Magadha in 750, and after it he established Pala dynasty. And the most famous or most important ruler of Pala dynasty was Dharmapala, which throned in 780 AD, and he was defeated by Nagbhat II in tripartite struggle. Dharmapala's kingdom was also visited by Suleiman, and he called it Ruma. Dharmapala also founded Somapur and Vikramshila University, one of the university which was famous in foreign countries also, like Nalanda, Takshashila and Vikramshila. These universities were famous in foreign countries because of providing their good level of education. Basically, after Dharmapala, we can say Dharmapala was succeeded by Devpala, who got victory over Huns, and he was beaten by Pratiharas. That's why the dynasty has to face its decline. Dharmapala was the most famous ruler. The most famous ruler who established Vikramshila University. He was a courageous commander and a skilled diplomat, and the Palas were great patrons of Buddhism, and that's why they encouraged Buddhist learning, and the University of Vikramshila was established with the support of literature and fine arts of Buddhism also. And the university attracted students even from foreign lands, as I have told you earlier. Suleiman visited his kingdom and he used the term Rumi for Palas. After Dhampala, the other important ruler was Mahendrapala. And in the court of Mahendrapala, the famous Koit Rajshekhar was residing, who wrote Kapoor Manjari, Kavya Mimamsa, Devpala was the last ruler of this dynasty. Who was defeated by Sena dynasty, who was Pala's power was destroyed by Sena dynasty, Vijaya Sena. Now we will see Rashtrakutas. This is the area of Rashtrakutas. We can say they were ruling Western Deccan and Malkhed. Malkhed was the capital of Rashtrakutas. The Rashtrakuta dynasty was established by Danti Durga. Where was it established? In Western Deccan. And the capital was Malkhed. That is also termed as Manyakheta. Amoghvarsha was the famous ruler of this dynasty. He was a poet also, and he wrote Kaviraj Marg and Prashnottar Mallika. Arab traveler Suleiman used the term Balhara for Rashtrakuta's kingdom. Basically, we can say the Rashtrakutas ruled for about 4 centuries, from the beginning of the 7th to the 10th century. And local self-government was one of the basic characteristics of Rashtrakutas. Or we can say local self-government played an important role in the villages. They were the devotees of Shiva and Vishnu. The rock-cut shrines at Ellora and Elephanta also belong to this period. We can say the famous temple of Ellora. The famous Shiv temple of Ellora was made by King Krishna I, who also belonged to Rashtrakuta dynasty. Shiva temple was built in Ellora and it was built by Rashtrakuta King Krishna I. Now we will see the Sisodias of Mewar also. Mewar was one of the most important kingdoms of Rajput. And its capital was Chittor. The fort of Chittor was captured by Alauddin Khilji during early 14th century. Some years later, another Rajput chief Hamir took it back and established the rule of Sisodias. Maharana Kumbha, Maharana Sangram Singh and Maharana Pratap were some of the famous and powerful rulers of Mewar. We can say the area of Chittor in Rajasthan was the kingdom, was the region of Sisodias of Mewar at that time. Basically, the 3 dynasties which has been discussed by me, the one is Pratihara dynasty, the second is Rashtrakuta dynasty, and the third is Pala dynasty. These were important because we can find tripartite struggle among these 3 dynasties. They were continuously fighting with each other. Why they were continuously fighting? Of course, to control the region of Kannauj. This is Kannauj. Because of getting control, all the 3 powers were fighting with each other so that they could control this fertile land of Kannauj, as the Kannauj was a land of Doab. Doab to river water. And which two rivers were flowing there? The one is Ganga and the other one is Yamuna. And because of flowing Ganga and Yamuna, this was the most fertile region. That's why all the three dynasties were continuously trying to capture this region. That's why they were indulged in tripartite struggle. Why this was termed as tripartite struggle? As the three parties, Pratihara, Palas and Rashtrakutas, were involved in this struggle, were involved in this battle. That's why this was termed as tripartite struggle. In our next video, we will discuss about Chauhan's and Chauhan's dynasty, and after it, we will discuss about Cholas.